Hello there. What's up, guys? Welcome back to the channel. My name is Justin, and today we're listening to Deacon Blues by Steely Dan, of course, off of their album Asia, which was released in 1977. I hope that you guys are having an absolutely fantastic day. Right now it is Sunday, relaxed. I went out early this morning, got some errands done. I got a dry vac or a wet dry vac so we could clean out the dishwasher because the dishwasher broke, so there's a bunch of water in there. So got that all set up. I'm gonna go ride my bike a little bit later and then probably go get a fire extinguisher because I like to be prepared. You never know what's gonna happen. But I hope that you guys are having a good day as well. You can join me on Twitter. You can join me in the comments down below. Thank you once again for all the support on the channel, and let's just do it. This is Deacon Blues by Steely Dan.
Shame, there where I used to stand.
isn't that like one of the smoothest songs, perhaps this whole album that you've ever heard? Like, I actually want to know. I have a question, really quick question before I start talking. If you don't like this song, I just want to know why you don't like this song. Do you think it's like too clean? It's too polished? It's too well produced? It's just too smooth? I just want to know. I actually just want to know. While I can't say that I've heard that song before, I feel like Steely Dan, I've heard maybe them in passing when I was a child and like riding in my parents' cars, like, you know, when they would take me on a trip. Because this type of music and Steely Dan sounds like, while I can't identify which bands and artists like I heard when I was like, you know, six, you know, I feel like I've grew up around this sound. And I think that that's one of the reasons why this is, for lack of a better word, hitting me a little bit differently. This soul, smooth, this like, I don't know, this sound that is just the epitome of smooth music. This sound is actually like what I grew up around, like as a child. Those nice, glossy, and relaxed keyboard notes, the guitar that comes in, the very tight drumming from none other than Bernard Purdy. I mean, he's one of my favorite drummers ever. He's one of the most charismatic drummers that I've ever seen. I love him so much. I'm surprised that while he was drumming, I didn't hear any "Ooh, yeah!" The backup harmonies and vocals that come in, as always, are so nice. They come in so soulfully. I love the R&B aspect. This is perfect music for today, which is a Sunday. I feel like this is an album you can just toss on and just let it go. Which I know you could do that with a lot of albums, but you know what I mean? Like this one, you could put it on and you could let it become background music, but at the same time, you're gonna pay attention to it. You're gonna be moving in your kitchen or wherever you are. If I was playing this song, if you're playing this video and you listen through with the song with me, I feel like you were probably moving, right? Like you're sitting right now, you're still, but let's be honest, like 3 minutes ago, you were probably bouncing around a little bit, right? See? Saxophone by Pete Chrisleep. And I'm sorry if I mispronounced that, but saxophone, beautiful, right? Once again, the epitome of smooth. This is paradise. This is paradise. This sound just like envelops itself around you. This like melts over you and you're just like lost in its rhythm. Singing by Donald Fagen. As always, it's just nice and relaxing. He has that yacht rock voice that, let's just be honest, you just sink into. The horn section is not to be unnoticed. It does come in a lot, providing a lot of extra melody to the song, but it doesn't become overblown. And the solo section as well sounds really good. And I like how throughout the song, it builds up, and it's a 7-minute song, but this is like one of the quickest 7-minute songs that I've heard. It doesn't feel at all like seven. It feels like maybe like four to me. Like, I love this soft escalation in the chorus. And then this little drum break near the ending of it. Come on, and that guitar there, Larry Carlton. It's a perfect song. It's a really good song, right? And I feel like the whole album is probably like this. I've already heard Asia, by the way, the title track. But I feel like the whole album is like this. It's like, I can see it. Talking about his solo, saxophone by Mr. Chris Lieb, he says that when they asked him, he says, "They told me to play what I felt." And he says, "Hey, I'm a jazz musician, that's what I do, so I recorded my first solo." We listened back, they said it was great. I recorded a second take, and that's the one they used. I was gone in half an hour. So he was done with that solo and his parts in 30 minutes. Okay, the next thing I know, I'm hearing myself in every bathroom airport in the world. Like, the way that he perfectly worked himself into the song, he knew what to do, he felt the music, he incorporated himself into it, and it pays off in the end. And like I said, I'm sure in passing or at some point I've heard this song because this, what I'm hearing from Steely Dan sounds like part of the soundtrack of me growing up as a child. But I don't think I've ever sat down and specifically listened to this song. Getting to the lyrics, "This is the day of the expanding man. That shape is my shade, that's where I used to stand. It seems like only yesterday I gazed through the glass at ramblers, wild gamblers, that's all in the past." As I was listening to this song and kind of following the story of this guy's thoughts, it sounds to me like someone who wants to accomplish something or is working their way up to something, but maybe it's more of like a fantasy rather than something realistic. Like they have a dream and they want to achieve it, but maybe it's not something that they can feasibly achieve. I like how the chorus are kind of like the inner thoughts of our guy. He says, learn to work the saxophone. I'll play what I just feel. I guess kind of like Mr. Chris Leap. Drink scotch whiskey all night and die behind the wheel. They got a name for the winners in the world. I want a name when I lose. They call Alabama the Crimson Tide. They call me Deacon Blues. I'm really assuming that Alabama Crimson Tide, I'm assuming is a football thing. I don't know sports. This is literally a guess. So maybe he wants to accomplish something in sports or in something related to that. I like the line that he says, they got a name for the winners in the world. He wants a name when he loses. So like he wants to get to the point that he's so popular that even when he loses, they know his name. You know, he's notorious. He wants to be at that level of infamy. And then in verse 3, he says, my back to the wall, a victim of laughing chance. This is for me the essence of true romance. Sharing the things we know and love with those of my kind, libations, sensations that stagger my mind. But the next verse, he says, I crawl like a viper through these suburban streets, make love to these women, languid and bittersweet. I'll rise when the sun goes down, cover every game in town, a world of my own, I'll make it my sweet home. It's a person that wants it all, but what are they doing to accomplish it? You know, like as far as I can tell, this is more of like a fantasy. So even the song title Deacon Blues, which to be honest, I'm not 100% sure how it relates to the song, but like at least on the blues end of things, blues, a music typically noted by its sadness and self-reflective themes. So him, maybe he's sad and he has the blues because he can't accomplish things that he wants. And he feels that, like, if he learns to play the saxophone, he'll be cool. Because, let's be honest, if you play saxophone, you're probably the coolest guy in town. Like, he wants to be that guy. This is the night of the expanding man. He's going to take himself and try to grow himself. He's going to expand himself and his horizons. Regardless of the message, the song's great. I mean, right? I mean, you guys knew that I was going to come to that conclusion when I listened to this. But, of course, I want to know your thoughts on the song. What do you think of the rest of this album? What is the best song on this album? What else do I have to look forward to in this album? You can join me on Twitter. You can join me in the comments down below. Thank you so much, as always, for watching this channel. I know that there are thousands and hundreds and millions, I'm sure, of other channels out there just like this. But I appreciate you for sticking with this one. Thank you for your donations. Don't forget to like the video if you enjoyed any of this. Don't forget to share it if you think someone else might enjoy it. And I'll talk to you guys later. My glasses are, like, going crooked. All right, I'll talk to you later. Bye.